Rejection, rejection, rejection. What should I do in 2021? Take easy, bro. We got 5 offers in a week. I will show you how to do it. Hi guys, this is Dr. Nancy Lee. I help people transition from worker bee to product manager and business leader. Recently, 5 of my students got offers within 1 week right before the Christmas. And some of them also got offers from Amazon, Microsoft, and LinkedIn. You may wonder, Nancy, I applied for hundreds of jobs. I still do not have an offer yet. And especially nowadays, Amazon had hiring freeze, and Google just laid off a bunch of product managers. Is there any chance for me in 2021? Don't worry, I got you covered. In this video, I'm gonna share with you the top 3 strategies to become a product manager in 2021. Actually, my student used the same strategy to land their product manager offers as well. Stay until the end of the video because I'm going to show you the referral bonus at the end of this video, which is the job openings at TikTok, and I can send your resume directly to the hiring manager. If you like any of the content and advice I provide, I would really appreciate if you hit the like button and turn it until it's blue. And if you want to learn the most effective way to become a product manager, please subscribe to this channel and turn on the red bell button so that you'll be notified every time I post a new video every Wednesday. Strategy number 1. Recruiting timing. During the pandemic, the recruiting timing has shifted and very different from any other year. In 2020, the recruiting started to pick up from September all the way until November. Most interviews and offers actually happening around October and November. For some companies, such as Google, actually they start to lay off some of the product managers around November. And as we're hitting December timeframe, Microsoft started to have a hiring freeze. So the market became very competitive recently. However, do not get worried because we're entering 2021. I believe 2021 is much better for everybody else out there. So in 2021, the recruiting will start to pick up again starting from January. And most companies will start to think about their timing, which is in general from January all the way until the end of April. That's a prime season for people to do recruiting. So I recommend all of you guys to have your resume ready and sharpen your interview skills as soon as possible, because once January hits, the job openings will flood in right away. If you do not get any offer by the end of April, I will start to worry a little bit because the recruiting season is likely to slow down during the summer. However, if you happen to have extra time or you miss the recruiting season, I recommend all of you guys to check out this free guide that you can build a product portfolio using this 13 project sheet. If you're looking for entry-level product manager position, I recommend all of you guys to focus on small, medium companies because the big fan companies APN offer has already gone out in the 2020. So for you guys, I will focus on small or medium companies because those companies wouldn't really think that far out about who they hire. On the other hand, I do not know how soon the hiring freeze of Microsoft and those companies will be over. If you are an experienced hire, you can actually apply for any companies and there's not specific timeline because any company that usually try to hire experienced hire based on the needs, so your timing will be much more flexible. But you should still keep in mind that most companies' offer will come before the end of April, so you should also get ready as well. If you're interested in startups and you have no time frame at all, because startups hire people all year round and once they make your offer, they want you to start tomorrow. So for example, one of my students, she got an internship offer from a startup in June, another one got an internship offer from a startup in July. So startup really hire people anytime. I've seen startup actually making offers around Christmas as well. And actually, do not underestimate startup because I am a big believer of startup. I believe that people can learn a lot by working in a startup environment. You know what? The startup can become the next TikTok. I'm off the deep end, watching. Please comment on the video and let me know what type of companies you're interested in, and I can tell you what their typical recruiting time frame. The second strategy is focus on efficiency. During the pandemic, you can never get a job just by playing the numbers game. I had some student reach out to me. He applied for like 1,000 jobs. Eventually, he exhausted those online applications and he only got 10 interviews and he got no offers out of those 10 interviews. So during the pandemic, I recommend all of you guys do not even apply for a job without a referral, because without a referral, you probably cannot even land an interview or an offer. I talk about the top networking strategy during the pandemic in my free webinar. You guys should check it out. My student actually used the same framework to land all the networking opportunities. So I believe you can use the same strategy to get your next job offer as well. Now let's talk about once you get an interview opportunity, what you should do. You need to be over prepared. I'm damn serious, over prepared. As I said, there are not that many job opportunities out there for you to do experiment and figure out what the best way to answer interview questions. So the best way to be over prepared to use the right product management interview framework. I already made other videos talk about the right framework to use. I'm not going to go in depth here, but you should definitely check out the must ask interview question. Tell me a time when you turn a product from concept to execution. You can check out the video here. And there's another framework I invented myself, which is for the product metrics framework. It's called My CS PhD framework. An hour long webinar give you examples how to use this framework to answer product metrics questions. So you should check out this video here. The third strategy is be smart about your work location. Lots of people made a mistake by putting the horse before the cart, which means when they interview any companies, they just tell them that, oh, I don't want to move. You know what? During the pandemic, everybody's working from home. And also the reality is that I don't think we are going back to the office until the summer of 2021, maybe even later. And do you know that lots of companies start to think about how to implement the work from home policy? So some of the employees can permanently work from home. And through the insider information, one of those fan companies is going to soon announce that they will let their employees to work from home permanently. Which company is it? I cannot discuss in this public forum. I only discuss this information in my private WeChat and LinkedIn group. So you can scan this barcode to submit your application to join the exclusive club. And I'm going to talk to you there in depth. When you discuss the work from home options with the recruiters during the interview, I will focus on getting offer first, then telling them I have to stay in my current cities, yada yada, because that will immediately make you a disqualified candidate. I will focus on, okay, my goal is to find the right company for me. We can talk about how exactly I can relocate or is necessary to relocate at all after the pandemic. So get an offer first. After you get an offer, you have two options. Option one is to accept the offer working from home during the pandemic. You know what? You can work from Hawaii if you want. And then do a kick-ass job in your current company. Make yourself irreplaceable. Once everything goes back to normal, 1 year later, you can discuss with the company about work from home permanently, because by that time, you're already irreplaceable with your company. The second option you can do is that once you have an offer and you start to negotiate with the current company about the relocation date, actually you can push out your relocation date to a large amount of time. The reason most people don't do it was because they don't know how to negotiate. So if you want to learn how to negotiate using the best strategy, you can check out this video here. We talk about the importance of networking again and again in my webinars and in this video. And here, let me give you the gift of 2021. I had a connection with the director of product at TikTok. He gave me 8 openings of his team, and I was able to pass any applicant directly to his inbox. So if you're interested in joining TikTok, and you can scan this barcode right now. On top of that, his team is also going to hire 40 product managers in 2021. If you're interested in TikTok, you can download this guide where you're able to get the email of the hiring manager directly. If you want to learn other strategy to become a product manager, even if you do not have product management experience, you should check out this video here. And if you like any of my videos I make, and feel free to give a thumbs up and share this video. And I wish all of you guys a happy 2021 and get more offers, get a handful of offers. I'm gonna see you soon, bye.